friends, welcome back. Today I'm here with statistical mean, and in this video we are going to see how to solve for mean by different kinds of methods such as direct method, shortcut method and step deviation method. And in this video we are also going to learn how to solve for different kinds of series such as discrete series and continuous series. So here we are going to find mean in this question. So we are given discrete series. We know discrete series are given with categories plus with their frequencies. No classes are given in discrete series. And here direct method is used to find mean. So the formula for direct method, that is sigma fx upon n. So where f belongs to frequency, x belongs to category, and n belongs to total number of frequencies. Here, according to formula, we need sigma fx. To obtain sigma fx, first of all, we are going to multiply f into x, means 10 into 5, 50, 20 into 2, 20, 30 into 3, 90, 40 into 8, 320, etc. And then we are going to obtain sigma fx, means whatever we got in fx, we are going to get its sum. So it will be 880. And to obtain n, we need to do total of frequencies, means 5 plus 2 plus 3 plus 8, 4 plus 3, etc. And we are going to get 25 at the end. And then we are going to divide sigma fx, means 880 upon 25. And we are going to obtain 35.2 as answer. In this question, we are going to use shortcut method to find mean. And the formula for shortcut method is equal to a plus sigma f dx upon n. Here a is assumed mean, which can be any value from column x, means we can take assumed mean 10 or 20 or 30. Here in this question I'm going to use assumed mean equal to 30. Now again, according to formula, we need sigma f dx. So to obtain that, we need dx first. So dx is equal to x minus a. So in first row, x is 10 and a is 30. The value of a is fixed, that is 30, and we are going to use the same single value of a, 30. So for the first row, the value of x is 10 and a is 30. So 10 minus 30 is equal to minus 20. And for second row, 20 minus 30 minus 10, and we are going to solve that. Now we need f dx. For obtaining f dx, multiply f into dx. So in first row, f is 5, dx is minus 20. So 5 into minus 20 is equal to minus under. In second row, frequency is 2 and dx is equal to minus 10. So answer will be minus 20. And so on, we are going to solve. And then we need sigma f dx, means we are going to sum up what we got in f dx. So after summing up, we get the answer, that is 130. And now we need n, that is sum up of all the frequencies, and that is 25. Now put all the values in the formula, that is 30 plus 130 upon 25. 130 upon 25 will be equal to 5.2. so 30 plus 5.2 is equal to 35.2. Here the last question, it is a continuous series because it contains classes, and we are going to solve it with step deviation method. And the formula for step deviation method is a plus f d dash m upon n into I, where a is assumed mean, I is class interval, m is middle value of a class. So for the first class, what is middle value of 0 and 10? That is 5. But if we want to solve with formula, that is lower limit of a class plus upper limit of a class upon 2, means 0 plus 10 upon 2, that is also equal to 5. So similarly, we're going to solve for other classes. In this question, the assumed mean will be taken from the m column, means it can be 5, 15 or 25. In this question, I have taken assumed mean 25. So dm will be equal to m minus a, as in the previous question, dx is equal to x minus a similarly. So in the first column, m is 5 and a is taken 25. So 5 minus 25 is equal to minus 20, and solve similarly for other rows also. Now d dash m will be equal to dm upon I, where dm is solved and I is a class interval. Class interval is solved by taking difference between upper and lower class limits, means in first row we can see 10 minus 0 is equal to 10. Second row, 20 minus 10, that is also 10. So class
interval here in this series is 10. Now for the first class, d dash m will be m upon I, that is minus 20, I is 10, so minus 20 upon 10 will be equal to minus 2. In second class, minus 10 upon 10, that will be equal to minus 1, and similarly we are going to solve for this. Now finally we obtained d dash m, so now according to formula we need f d dash m, so now multiply frequency with d dash m. So in first class, 20 into minus 2 is equal to minus 40. In second class, 24 into minus 1 is equal to 24, and similarly solve for other classes. Now to obtain sigma fdm, we need to sum up answers of fdm. So minus 40 plus minus 24 plus 0 plus 36, 40 is equal to 12. So we need to put all these values we obtained into our mean. So in this question, you have taken assumed mean as 25. And this question you are going to solve with Podmas rules. So you are going to solve first multiplication and division means fd dash upon n into I. So that will be equal to 12 into 10 upon 140. So that is equal to 0.857. And then you're going to add with 25. So that will be equal to 25.875.